Hey there, my dear friends. Today I have got something really special to share with you in this video. It's a technique I like to call the one layer technique. This little gem is my secret weapon when it comes to skin retouching, creating that flawless skin texture we all desire and so much more. Now picture this, you are in a rush and you need to retouch some skin quickly, but time is not on your side. That's when I turn to my trusty one layer technique. It's like having a magic wand for quick effective skin editing. What makes this technique even more amazing is that despite its name, it's completely non-destructive. You see, you can fine tune these settings to suit your image size and the specific type of skin you are working on. Flexibility and efficiency rolled into one. So no more wasting precious time, let's dive right into this tutorial and unlock the power of one layer technique. Your skin retouching game is about to reach a whole new level. Alright guys, here is the photo we will be working with in this tutorial. Take a look and you can see that her skin isn't quite flawless at the moment. But don't worry, we are about to work some magic on it. Our goal to transform her skin into something akin to that smooth model-like texture we all admire. Now let's kick things off with the first step. It's super simple, just duplicate the layer by pressing Ctrl or Cmd+J on your keyboard. This duplicated layer is going to be our sole player in this technique. And remember, I mentioned that this method is non-destructive, right? To keep things non-destructive, we are going to turn this layer into a smart object. It's as easy as right-clicking on the layer and selecting Convert to Smart Object. This nifty little trick allows us to make adjustments without damaging our original image. So let's go ahead and make that layer smarter. Alright, it's time to take the next step in our process. We are going to apply the high-pass filter. You probably have a pretty good idea of what the high-pass filter does, but just in case, it's a fantastic tool for enhancing the fine details in an image. To get started, navigate to filter menu, then head over to other and there you will find high pass. Click on it. Now when it comes to settings, the radius, you have got some creative freedom. Feel free to choose a radius that you think works best for your image. Don't worry, you can always fine tune this later to match your preferences. So go ahead and experiment with it. In this case, a radius of 40 pixels might just be the sweet spot for enhancing this particular image. Once you have made your selection, hit OK to apply the high pass filter. Now as you look at your screen, you will notice that the image has transformed into a grayscale high pass layer. To truly appreciate the fine details we have enhanced, we need to bring those vibrant colors back into the mix. To accomplish this, all you need to do is change the layer blending mode to linear light. Linear light is a blending mode that has a knack for intensifying both highlights and shadows, giving your image a more dynamic and vibrant appearance. It's like a magician's wand for bringing out the best in your photos. Now we want to emphasize texture and contour in the image. We need to apply the invert command. Navigate to image menu at the top of your Photoshop window. From there, go down to adjustments and finally select invert. Alternatively, if you are a fan of keyboard shortcuts, you can simply press Ctrl or Cmd+I. So what exactly does this do to your high pass filter layer? When you apply the invert command to your high pass filter layer, it essentially reverses the tonal values of the image. Areas that were previously dark become light and vice versa. So shadows become highlights and highlights become shadows. This inversion can have the effect of making the edges and fine details in your image stand out more. This can often increase the overall contrast in your image, making it look more striking and defined. This technique is often used for various purposes, including enhancing details and creating interesting effects. It's particularly useful in context of skin retouching, where you want to emphasize the texture and contours. Now let's talk about what happens when we apply the invert command. It can have an unexpected impact on our image. You will notice that, as I mentioned earlier, dark areas become light and light areas become dark. While this can be beneficial for some images, it might introduce a bit of unwanted ghosting and halos around the edges, which isn't always ideal. To remedy this situation and bring out image back to its desired look, we will employ the levels adjustment. Open up your adjustment panel, select levels. Now, to make sure this adjustment only affects our high pass filter layer and doesn't interfere with the rest of our image, we are going to create a clipping mask. This essentially limits the impact of the adjustment to just the layer below it. Once you have got your levels adjustment set up, you will see those sliders. First, grab the black slider in the levels adjustment panel and gently drag it to the right. This will help to bring back some of the darker tones without overdoing it. Similarly, slide the white slider to the left. This action helps to reclaim some of the lighter tones while preventing any excessive whitening. This nifty move will help us restore the proper contrast and brightness, effectively addressing the issues caused by the inversion. It's like fine-tuning your image to bring it back to its natural glory. So go ahead and make those adjustments to get things looking just right. Okay, good. Now our image might currently look completely blurred without a trace of that beautiful texture we want to showcase. But don't worry, we are going to bring the texture back by adding a touch of Gaussian blur. Yes, I know it sounds a bit funny, adding blur to enhance texture, but trust me, it works like magic. Head over to the filter menu, then scroll down and select blur. And there it is, Gaussian blur, click on it. Now, when it comes to setting the blur radius, you don't need to go overboard. A small radius will do the trick. You can always fine-tune this later on to match your specific preferences and the unique characteristics of your image. It's all about finding that perfect sweet spot, balance between the smoothness and details. So go ahead and apply that Gaussian blur. Now let's take a closer look. If you zoom in, you will start to notice that beautiful skin texture coming back to life. However, there is a catch. Right now, it's applied all over the image, and that's not what we want. We need to be more precise and limit this effect to only the skin. So add an inverted layer mask to this layer. To add an inverted layer mask, hold down the Alt key on your keyboard. While holding the Alt key, click on the layer mask icon at the bottom of your layers panel. It makes the entire mask black, effectively hiding the effect. Now grab a soft edged brush, select the color white, and start painting on the areas where you want to reveal that lovely texture. Take your time, go slow, and be careful. The key here is precision. You want to bring back the texture only where it belongs, which is on the skin. This step is all about finesse and getting the best possible result, so don't rush it and enjoy the process. Great job, you have made it through the main steps, and now it's time to add your personal touch and fine-tune the texture to your liking. Simply open up the high pass filter and Gaussian blur layers that we have worked with. Inside each of these layers, you will find the radius adjustment. Now it's all about finding that sweet spot for your particular image. You can tweak the radius amount to achieve the level of texture and smoothness that best suits your creative vision. Remember, this step is where you can really make the technique your own. Depending on the image and your preferences, you might want a more pronounced texture or smoother look. Take your time experimenting with the settings until you achieve that perfect balance that brings out the best in your photo. That's it, guys. Take a look at the before and after. That's it for this video, guys. I would like to kindly ask you for a small favor. If you find this video helpful and want to see more valuable tips and tricks, please consider subscribing to this channel. It's the best way to stay updated on all the latest content. And if you enjoy what you see today, don't forget to hit that like button, share this video with your friends, and drop a comment to let me know how I can further assist you. Your support means the world to me. Stay tuned for our next video. Take care. Happy editing.